Hey, you, AMC shareholder. Holding shares, AMC? You got a lot of them? All right. Check this out, right? Did the shorts cover? No? Fuck are we talking about? Okay, you're probably wondering, what the fuck is going on? Phil hasn't said shit. Phil, what is your thoughts on everything? Well, let me tell you something, man. We all know what's up. We all know what's up. We all know that they're going to dip into their others. The other shit they got. They got to dip into it all. They got to dip into it all. And when it just keeps kicking going down the road, we will still be there. We'll still be there. Did the shorts cover? No. What are we talking about then? I'm still here. Remember, people, you have to be ready for these types of things. It doesn't matter what it says. Think about this. I want you to think about this while you're wondering, like, man, this is real low and I look like this. Oh, I'm so fucking frustrated. No, listen. Think about this, especially when you got in a little bit earlier. You already know what's up. But, and I know some of you got in late, and that's understandable too. You're dipping in red. But most of us who got in earlier, we know what's up. So, when it goes up, you know, $100, then it shoots back down to 30. Like, are you going to be able to handle some shit like that? Like, you have to be able to understand what type of game this is, you know, what they're playing with it. So it's like manipulating, you know, they're just doing all type of shit to it, right? So just know that, you know, there are certain things that's happening. And, you know, I don't know the answers to them all the way. You know, I just know they are happening. So, and it's happening before our eyes, and we're all just seeing this shit. I'm sure you're seeing this shit, wondering like, what the fuck is going on. So, hey man, you gotta be able to handle this shit, no matter what the share price is. That's just the truth. Like, you have to be able to handle when it goes up, when it goes down, when it goes up, when it goes down. You have to handle this roller coaster ride we told you called AMC. All right, AMC, telling you, you see. The data itself speaks for itself. I don't have a chart right here to just, I'm just speaking how I feel. You know what I'm saying? So with this shit, man, you know, I don't know. It's just like a roller coaster. You just have to hold on and just never sell. Why would you sell your shares? Doesn't make sense, right? So at this point, you'd be like, oh, I just want to sell. Nah, dog. Doesn't matter. Listen, the more you have, the better it will be for you. Oh, man. Diamond hand boss. I'm a diamond hand boss. For what it costs, I'm a diamond hand boss. Hold, never fold. Then buy some more. Yeah. But it is what it is, man. I love it. I love this train that we're on. Hey, you trying to ride with us? Ride with us then. We here, man. Ride with us. The shares you have are definitely, I mean, can think about it, you know, dated and timed. You know what I'm saying? So, you think about that. Yeah. So, hold, never fold. Yeah. And don't worry about it, Mr. KG. Yeah. We ain't worried about you. I ain't worried about you. You keep that constitution, boy. Trying to change the narrative. It can't change. Because you know what's going to happen. But I have the Constitution. You should believe me. Well, why are all these motherfuckers sliding and shit, riding and everything? I don't know what's going on. Do you know what's going on? Yeah. But I got the Constitution. I don't care. You're responsible for all this shit. Oh, man. I'm holding my shares. Simply put, I don't care. I'm good. Happy. I'm alive. So should you. Keep calm with this shit. This shit is nothing. This shit is nothing. Like, literally. It's a grown-up talk right now. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got this. Trust and believe. You know, it's coming, people. You just have to be ready, mentally ready for this shit. You know, I'm just keeping it real with you. And so, hope you have a good weekend. I'm chilling with my fam. Chilling. And that's the reason why you see me kind of like tired is because I've been like, we partied real hard for that Bone Thug and 3-6 party. We partied hard, okay? I partied hard. I got like videos, like I was dancing. And y'all have to understand, like I was a 3-6 fan. I was a 3-6 fan, okay? For like, since I was like in eighth grade. Okay. Like, I had to tear the Club of Thugs tape. Okay. So I had the tape. And the first song I hear on tape, you know, of course I'm listening to the album, but the song that struck me crazy was Slob on My Knob. Like, I was like, whoa. And this was like, I was in seventh, eighth grade. Yeah, more like seventh grade. So I heard it in seventh grade. Heard it. I was like, oh, that shit is nice. And I just threw it all in the school. Everybody listened to the shit. Everybody was like, yo, this shit is dope. Who is this? I said, this is Juicy J. You know what I'm saying? Like, because I was a fan of 3-6. Because I grew up, listen, I don't know if you remember. There was a, if you had no cable, right? We grew up poor. You know what I'm saying? Sorry. I didn't grow up rich. So we had the box. So if you had no cable back in the 90s, you had like the antenna, like any channels. So we grew up with the box. And the box, you could like order music videos and shit like that. And so, you know, when it comes to that, you know, they used to play like little trailers for a video that you want to like watch, or you know, they'll play. So they used to always play Tenor Club of Thugs with Hot Boys, and you know, Hot Boys and No Limit and all that was hot at the time. So I used to always see it like on repeat. So, you know, it was cool to see that. And so the first thing I did on my birthday was I went and bought a Tenor Club of Thugs tape so I could listen to all their music. So that night, okay. That night, I'm being for real with you guys. That night, right, we, you know, when Juicy J did that, you know, the whole business, that shit, it was crazy, man. That shit was wild. Like, I got videos of us reacting to it. Like, it's, I wish I could throw a mashup together. I probably will, but it's crazy. But, yeah. So, when he did Slob on My Knob, everybody was like, he's not gonna do it. I'm like, yeah, the fuck he is. If he doesn't do that song, he know why he's there. Come on. We knew why Juicy J was gonna be there. So he did Slob on My Knob. It was over. Everybody singing the words. Everybody's like, it's like late night, and everybody's like, freeze on my nuts? What the hell are they screaming? It was crazy. Long night, trust me, long few days. Like, I just was, yeah, I was lit as fuck. I'm telling you, it was great. Great time, trust me, with my friends, because I've been losing friends, losing family, people we know. So it's like getting real tough to like, you know, deal with some of these things. You know, you have to deal with them the best way you can and just hang out with people that's here, and then you just love them, embrace them while you're here. And, you know, That's what it is. In the midst of that, I'm holding AMC shares. So, you know, just keeping it real. So I'm holding my AMC shares, and I'll, you know, if it dips even lower, great, cool. I'll just buy some fucking more. Just buy some more. So I'm good. I mean, shit, the money's already in there. Shit, I'm not even thinking about it. Like, are you thinking, like, come on. You know what time it is, especially if you've been in this for a little minute. You know what time it is. So, shouldn't have to say too much, because you don't really need me to speak. You know, I'm just really just, hey, man, I'm holding my shares. Did the shorts cover? No. The fuck are we talking about, then? You know? You know why? You know why? You know what's up? But anyways, I've been doing more research on, like, the NFTs, because, I mean, I'm new to the shit. Like I said, I'm not a stock guru. I'm just some guy on the internet, you know? So, just been researching a lot about it and talking and looking at what I would sell my shit for. Like, Phil, what would you do? Like, okay, listen, I know there's only 86,000 of us out here, right, that got it. So, if you got it, listen to me. What would you sell your shit for? Because right now they punching people out for it. So I don't know. I'm thinking treating my shit like a Tesla. So when it comes to my shit, you know, I don't know. Who knows? We'll see what it is. We'll see what's up. But hold on to my shit. I'm telling you. All right. So